I'm Carnell Davis, and on this segment, we'll focus on the Mobile Bay chapter of the American Red Cross's Project Share program that began accepting applications this week. And we have with us a special guest, Ms. Sandra Kennedy. She's the Social Service Director at the American Red Cross to tell us about Project Share. Ms. Kennedy, thank you for coming out on Impact.
Thank you, Mr. Davis.
Project Share, tell our audience exactly what this program is all about.
Okay. Project Share, and the actual term SHARE stands for Service to Help Alabamians with Relief on Energy, is a program that was developed in 1982 between the American Red Cross and the state of Alabama and Alabama Power Company to meet the rising cost of energy for the elderly and disabled. So this program was designed to assist them during the heating season to pay some of those large heating bills that were developing as a result of the high cost of energy.
And the American Red Cross, of course, administers Project Share.
Yes, we do.
And we're located here in Mobile County. How are the other counties, the contiguous counties, how is it administered, Project Share? Is it available, say, in Baldwin County and Washington County? How would people who live in Baldwin County and Washington County apply?
The American Red Cross in Baldwin County and Washington County would have funds to administer the program. And just as we would here in Mobile.
Now, where do you get your funding as far as the monies that you expend on the individuals who are eligible? How is it funded, Project Share?
Project Share is basically funded through the energy our consumers. Say, for instance, Project Share for Alabama Power receives the largest amount. We also have Alabama Gas up in northern Alabama who contributes to Project Share. Well, the customers do. And then I think it's about 8 other suppliers that collect for Project Share.
When you get your electric bill from Alabama Power Company, there's a certain time of the year where you can designate a dollar. I think it's a dollar a month. Is that the monies that we're talking about?
Yes. That's how you can really.
And for someone who's listening in, can they still designate that dollar, now that they know what this program is all about, can they still designate that dollar through the power company, or how would they go about contributing to Project Share?
They can notify the power company that they wish to participate in the Project Share program. And also, if they do not wish to do it that way, they can make their contribution directly to the American Red Cross.
Now, let's get to the serious part. Who is eligible for Project Share, and how is eligibility determined? Now, we do have some of the qualifications, if we can get that on the screen, but tell us who is eligible for Project Share.
Generally, in terms of the eligibility criteria for Project Share, it's very simple. An individual family can apply if the head of the household, who is the one that should apply, is over 62 years or older, or if the head of the household is on disability, thereby limiting their ability to maintain a substantial income to take care of their family. We have two small criteria that we also utilize in terms of determining eligibility, and that is someone who is temporarily unemployed due to illness or injury, and they're also the head of the household. They may apply. And then we have another group of individuals who have to take care of children that may be on SSI or adults that may be on SSI, and thereby limiting their ability to become employable because of the round-the-clock care.
So the information that's on the screen, 62 years of age or older, disability income, temporarily income interrupted through illness or injury, or a person is required to take care of a household member on SSI. Now, you can meet one of those eligibility criteria.
One of those.
So if a family falls under either one of those, they would possibly be eligible for Project Share.
Right. And of course, we have an income guide that goes along with those specific situational criteria.
Okay. The next question is, how does one apply for Project Share?
Okay. Basically, one applies by just contacting the Red Cross and saying to us that they wish to apply, and we will determine their eligibility and set up an appointment for them to come in.
And do you have, is there a large number of people who apply for this program?
We think so. We had last year, which was one of our leanest years, we assisted 900 and some families, but during our largest year, we may have assisted about 1,300 families in that program.
Now, I read the news release and it said that applications are accepted by appointments.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Is there, most programs you just walk in and you apply. Why is it set up where you only apply for through appointments? And the other question is, who determines if a person is eligible?
Okay. The reason that we set up appointments, we feel that it's more beneficial and easier for the client to have an appointment so that at that time they can bring to us all of the documentation that we will need to determine eligibility. Now, if they just walk in off the street and say, I want to apply, 9 times out of 10, you would have to send them back anyway to say that you need to go home and get this proper verification or you need to do this or that. So we encourage them to call for appointments, and it would make it easier on them. You could save time, and instead of 2 or 3 trips, you could just make 1 trip.
And so the Red Cross interviewers and eligibility technicians are the ones who actually determine who is eligible.
Well, they will go by, of course, the criteria that we have there, and as we do have supervisors who actually approve the applications after they've been received.
And now, once again, how would one apply? And then, more importantly, for our viewing audience, if individuals would like to contribute to Project Share, how would they go about doing that?
Okay. Call the Red Cross and identify yourself as an individual wanting to apply for assistance for Project Share, and that would give, they will then be given a worker, a Project Share worker, a volunteer. And those of you who would like to give to the American Red Cross or the Project Share program, basically contact the power company, or if the power company is still printing the on the top of your bill that you can share a dollar, check that, mark that, and say you'll share a dollar. And this would mean $12 a year. And if you do not have the opportunity to do that, just mail a check made to the American Red Cross Project Share.
And people can get assistance not only with their, it's heating, electrical, whether it be gas, coal, wood.
Whatever their heating source is.
Now, we do realize, and we have an announcement from Mobile Community Action, if we can get that on the screen. We do realize that Project Share is a program that is not as large as the Community Action program, but Mobile Community Action, low-income home energy assistance program. If you can't get a quick appointment with Project Share, call the Red Cross. But in the meantime, you can apply at Mobile Community Action for its low-income home energy assistance program. Applications are accepted at all of the Community Action service centers on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays, with Thursdays set aside for senior citizens and persons with handicapping conditions. Now, this program also assists low-income families with the cost of energy, and you can call Mobile Community Action at 457-5700. Tell them you heard it on Impact. Ms. Kennedy, thank you for coming out, joining us, and we'll see you next week on Impact.
Thank you.
If you think the Enterprise is getting on in years,
hey, look out for that asteroid!
Wait till you see its crew.
Help! I've fallen and I can't get up!
In living color.
Bones, please do something. Damn it, Jim. I'm a corpse, not a doctor.
Catch an all-new episode. Then, George Wendt gets dumped by Rhea Perlman.
You did cheat on her.
White man, dig it.
Tonight, starting at 7 on Fox 15.
Gulf Coast Most Wanted is brought to you by Mobile Gas, Fox 15, WPMI, and 95KSJ. I'm Wayne Gardner. This week's criminal is wanted in Mississippi for 2 counts of capital murder and 1 count of murder. Moises Alonzo Tinajero is considered armed and dangerous. He has a tattoo on his arm that says death before dishonor. Tinajero is a 30-year-old Hispanic male. If you have any information about Moises Tinajero, please call the number on your screen. Gulf Coast Most Wanted is a public service of Mobile Gas, Fox 15, WPMI, and 95KSJ.
Recycling a glass bottle saves enough energy to run the TV you're watching for 1 full hour. Recycle. It's the everyday way to save the world.
You're watching Fox 15 WPMI Mobile Pensacola. The following is a paid program.
All Christian Radio. WPCS 89.5 FM Stereo. 24 hours a day, every day. Wherever you are, wherever you go, All Christian Radio provides God's good news of salvation through music and message. Enjoy WPCS 89.5 FM Stereo, All Christian Radio. From the beautiful Gulf Coast of Northwest Florida, Pensacola Christian College presents Rejoice in the Lord.